57 migrants are presumed dead today off the coast of Libya as refugees and migrants continue their desperate journey to Europe. But in the country that has borne the heaviest load amid the crisis, police in Greece have launched a human trafficking prosecution against nonprofits that help asylum seekers try to avoid being pushed back at sea to Turkey. Last week, special correspondent Malcolm Brabant reported on violent pushbacks by the Greeks at sea. But as Malcolm also found, pushbacks are happening on the River Evros, along the land border between Greece and Turkey.
It took persistence for Huda and her three children to reach Greek soil. They were pushed back to Turkey three times before finally crossing the sea to the island of Samos.
Can you just describe to me how you feel about the way in which you've been treated?
It's like going from one war to another. I didn't find anything better here than the life I was living.
The Palestinian family's three pushbacks happened on the treacherous Evros River, a militarized zone dividing Greece from Turkey.
Can you describe what happened when you were pushed back?
They pushed us back in a very aggressive way. On the way back to Turkey, we were ordered into a boat meant for just three or four people. They put 32 people in all together with some Syrians that work with them. They put us all in the river and sent us back. They told us that 2 days before, someone fell in the water and died. They said if you return here, you will have the same fate.
This Kurdish woman is laying low in the Greek capital, Athens. She's afraid Turkish agents will kidnap her, take her back to Turkey and throw her in jail. She's a vocal opponent of Turkey's increasingly authoritarian President Erdogan and fled to Greece to seek political asylum. Like these migrants, she boarded a small boat and paddled across the Evros River to the European Union side, but was pushed back by Greek border guards in breach of international conventions stipulating that asylum seekers should not be expelled if their lives or freedom are at risk, and especially not back into the arms of their persecutors.
Being a refugee is a right, unfortunately, because if only everyone could live freely and economically secure. If only there were no wars in people's countries, but they all exist and people have the right to live. They have the right to a better life without going to prison, without being killed.
Spiros Economou of the Greek Council for Refugees is outraged by pushbacks of any kind.
Well, it's the most blatant violation of international human rights law. It actively places in danger people's lives and rights. I don't really see anything being more dreadful. And in all honesty, it's an international shame.
Greece is currently erecting a Donald Trump-style wall along the Evros. Greece has the dilemma of feeling abandoned by its European Union partners because so many nations refuse to accept migrants. And at the same time, it's obliged to defend the EU's borders. Migration Minister Notis Mitsotakis.
We don't want to be the gateway to Europe for the smuggling networks. We don't want to be the gateway for millions of people to enter the European Union through Greece and end up in all the member states of the European Union. But we still feel we're alone. Greece, Italy, Spain, Malta, and Cyprus, the five Mediterranean countries, in tackling the pressure from migration.
The battle over the Greek pushbacks is heating up. The police on the Greek islands next to the Turkish coast have just launched a prosecution against international non-profits and some individuals who help asylum seekers and who've criticised pushbacks. The police say they may be well-meaning, but they have committed felony crimes such as people trafficking and espionage.
Veteran humanitarian and political analyst Panayoti Dimitras is fighting back. He's been to Greece's Supreme Court to demand that a prosecutor investigates hundreds of pushbacks by the state.
Europe should be more ashamed than anybody else because it's their orders that are being carried out by all the other players. It is their policies, their agreements that are at the root of the problem.
What a difference 5 years makes. Spring 2016. And Portuguese coast guards are racing to rescue Syrians in distress off the island of Lesbos. The Portuguese were contributing to the European border agency Frontex and saving lives. Fast forward to this decade and footage of a Romanian Frontex ship apparently pushing back migrants towards Turkey. In a damning report, the European Parliament has condemned Frontex for failing to uphold its human rights obligations. Frontex, based in Warsaw, responded by saying it would look into the Parliament's recommendations about improving.
Europe should change, and if Europe changes, every other player will be forced to change.
Dimitras is disturbed by the trend of criminalizing pro-migration non-profits. These people were saved off the coast of Libya in June as they tried to reach Italy. Their rescuers were from Doctors Without Borders, whose ship, the Geo Barents, replaced other vessels outlawed in Italian waters. After landing the migrants in Sicily, the ship was detained for 24 days for what the non-profit described as punitive reasons. But it was released today, spokeswoman Barbara Deck.
Since the beginning of 2021 up till now, at least 790 people have been confirmed dead or missing. The need to be back at sea is imminent. We cannot let people perish at the deadliest sea border of the world.
Back on the Greek island of Samos, Huda has now been granted asylum. The Greeks accepted she was escaping conflict and poverty, but above all, protecting her children from an extremely abusive father.
I want my children to be in a place where they are not afraid. I want them to be safe. I want them to study. I want them to be like any children, like any child that loves to play, that goes to school, that finds a familial environment where there's respect for their childhood.
In Athens, the Kurdish asylum seeker issued this appeal.
All of Europe, all of the world has to be against this. We cannot turn our backs on people who had to escape wars and dictatorships that our very own states foster. If we are not able to stop wars and migration, we have to make sure that they happen in humanitarian conditions.
What's drawing migrants to the European Union are its democratic and humanitarian principles. Currently, all along its frontiers, critics argue those values are being tarnished, and they wonder, how long will the hypocrisy continue? For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Malcolm Brabant in Athens.